spirit free, that I might praise thy name. Let all bondage go, and let deliverance flow. Set my spirit free to worship.
Hello, this is Pastor Tim Carter of Forsyth Friends Meeting. I hope you're having a great morning. I know I am. Looking forward to talking with you this morning. I have some thoughts to share that I think will bless you. We're not having our regular Sunday meetings at this time, so I'm writing a written message. If any of you prefer to receive a in-writing message for a reader, I'd be glad to send one of those out to you. Just write me at timothygrantcarter@gmail.com. timothygrantcarter@gmail.com. The contact information for Forsyth Friends Meeting was up just a few moments ago, and I hope you got that. It'll be up again at the end of the message. Wanted to talk with you this morning about a pet phrase of mine, a phrase that I use a lot and it means a lot to me, and really I think it should mean a lot to you. It's called rigid flexibility. Well, that's a strange term. I come up with lots of strange terms. Sometimes I'm joking with people and I call myself a strange duck, but it seems to fit. Recently, before we suspended the services recently because of a health scare due to COVID-19, one of the friends at the meeting was talking with me after the service, and they moved the pulpit from one place in the fellowship hall to another place in the fellowship hall. I wanted to know what I thought about it. And I said, that's just great. Rigid flexibility. Roll with the punches. And one of the ladies said, that's interesting. You'll have to tell us more about it. And I took that to heart. So I wrote a message on rigid flexibility and started to bring it the next Sunday morning, but I realized that there was so much to say that I could barely scratch the surface. But nonetheless, I did, but only got about 30% of the thoughts that I wanted to share. So it gives me a reason to come back to the topic, rigid flexibility, and talk with you this morning about it. Rigid flexibility means to be always committed to being flexible. 1 Corinthians 10:31 and Acts 9:15 make it pretty plain that whatever we do, we should do it for God. You know, and a lot of people always interpret that, well, you know, we're doing great things, we're doing fun things, we're doing pleasant things. But no, I think the scripture makes it plain that even if it's suffering, we can do it for God. And as a matter of fact, when we include him in those plans and are willing to experience whatever it is we need to experience in this life, and we don't fight it, we're somewhat flexible with it, and we grow through it, then we find that God is with us in those experiences, and we learn what we're supposed to learn from them. I remember years ago, I'm confessing my age here, Tanya Tucker came out with a song, and she talked about the tree in her backyard, and that it was strong enough to bend with the wind. And that tree, being strong enough to bend with the wind, made it able to stand storms and the tests of time. And our lives really are like that. If we're somewhat flexible, if we'll bend instead of break, then things that come through our life that could devastate or destroy us, instead of completely tearing us down, they teach us something so that we can grow through those seasons and see something of God's special touch, even in the midst of them. Colossians 3:17 makes it plenty plain that Healthy spiritual growth includes gratitude. Well, what does gratitude have to do with rigid flexibility? You know, if I'm willing to be flexible and see whatever the circumstances coming my way actually have God's fingerprints on them, then I can't help but be grateful because I know that God will be with me through those experiences. And guess what? He'll be with you through the experiences of your life. And you can develop an attitude of gratitude even in the challenging circumstances. And certainly in 2020, we had plenty of them, and it looks like they're here to stay for a while. So knowing that we can be flexible and that we can experience the touch and hand of God, even through the tough experiences of life, gives us a resiliency like that tree in the backyard so that we can stand the test of time and weather the storms. You know, sometimes people get in very rigid and fixed ways of thinking, and it's almost like they box themselves in so that they can't learn. I think a way to describe that is it's square box compliant. Well, you got to be this way, and it's got to be this size, and no more. And if it's not, then it's not square box compliant, and we just can't have that. Well, I don't know. I think our minds are a brilliant piece of God's engineering, and that we can think outside some of those boxes and come up with some pretty amazing answers to what's going on in our life to share with our friends and help our neighbors. 1 Peter 4:12 through 19 make it pretty plain that we need to expect some trials in this life. I'm a karate teacher, so I tell people they need to learn to roll with the punches, and that's true. You know, you're going to experience some. They come your way. They're part of the fight of life. You know, that some mighty mean and ornery punches are going to come your way. And you might as well expect them and be prepared to deal with them. Be ready to roll. I remember after 9/11, there was an amazing hero. His name was Todd Beamer, and he stopped the terrorists with the help of some other passengers. He stopped those terrorists from wrecking that plane into the Pentagon, or more people would have died. And when he got ready to act and to try to stop the plane from being wrecked and definitely stop it from being taken over, he looked at the other passengers who were going to help him, and he said, "Let's roll." I think that's what rigid flexibility says. We see what we need to do, even if there's a sacrifice involved, and we say, "Let's get it done. Let's roll." Flexibility, though, I think it does have to be rigid. What do I mean by rigid? Well, there has to be an established pattern of being pliable. Not just pliable sometimes, but pliable all the time, except that pliableness that causes us not to break in the storm causes us to be strong when we need to be, when we need to have backbone for the cause and case of others that we love. We need a propensity to roll, a ready to move and bend attitude, so that when things come our way, it's okay. We can deal with it. We have that mindset. If Matthew chapter 9, verse 17 talks about old wineskins and new wineskins. Well, if you put new wine in old wineskins, such as what they were talking about in the Old Testament, it will ferment and cause the old wineskins to split, and you'll lose your wine. So if you put new wineskin in a container, and back then they used leather skins, you put it in a new wineskin so that it's soft and supple, and as the wine ferments and changes into its full nature and character, then the skin is designed to hold it and to expand with it. And our lives need to be flexible like that. You know, some things are going to happen, and if we get old and rigid and can't be molded and changed in any way, then, you know, these experiences can destroy us instead of making us what we're supposed to be. I think about the potter. God's the potter. I'm the clay. And when I'm soft and pliable in the hands of God, I can be strong and mighty in the affairs of life. I like to think of that as a good reason why to be rigidly flexible. Rigid flexibility is and should be a standard operating procedure for me. If you get around companies very much, they talk about SOP. Standard operating procedure. How do we normally do things? What is it that we normally do. Well, I'm normally rigidly flexible. I can roll with situations. I have some standards and I bring them into the situation. But if I need to adapt or change or just look at things just a little bit differently, I can do that too. I think it's great to have definiteness. I think it's great to have structure. Structure is like the bone of the body. No structure, no form. No form, no purpose. But you know, when we have the flesh, and then we have the muscle, and then we have the sinew, and we have the ligaments, and without these moving parts of the body, these flexible, these pliable parts, you know, bone's not very useful by itself. So we need structure going into a situation and then to be flexible enough to adapt and change in the situation as God would want us to. 1 Corinthians verses chapter 12, verses 4 through 7 talk about spiritual gifts. I believe that spiritual gifts were God's way of helping us help each other. Some people think that we shouldn't be our brother's keeper, but I think we should. That's why I'm bringing this message this morning, is to reach out to some of you and to tell you about the love of God, that Jesus cares for you. I care for you. That's why I'm sharing this message. And I'm trying to let the very Christ who helps me to be flexible enough in my heart to grow through the storms of life help you see that you, by putting your hand in His hand and having that flexible nature, I like to think it ties in with what the Scripture says about the fruits of the Spirit. We have the fruits of the Spirit when we're open and compliant to the will and the nature and the guiding and the directing of God. And so I hope this morning that you'll let God give you that kind of rigid flexibility. Romans 8, 35 through 39 makes it plain that nothing can separate us from Christ's love. Wow, what a comfort. What a great peace of mind knowing that there's a love in my heart that can never be taken from me. And because of that, this very rigid compliance that turns into a flexible nature that can grow and bend in a tough storm instead of break lives on the inside of me. Nothing can separate me from God's love, and God's love can lead me and guide me and direct me in every situation. Did you know that God's love can lead you, and guide you, and direct you? If you just open up your heart and give Him a chance, let Him show you how through the direction of His Spirit. That's why we have to be a little flexible so the Lord can teach us something that we don't already know. And there's a lot that we don't already know. We need to be open to the moving of His Holy Spirit. You know, acceptance needs to be a state of mind that we have all the time. And I don't mean acceptance that you're being stepped on. I don't mean acceptance that you don't have any firm convictions. I don't mean acceptance that you're not ever willing to stand up for right. I don't mean that at all. What I mean about acceptance is when you have to deal something and something comes your way, pleasant or unpleasant, that you call it what it is. You know, that you see situations for what they are, that you accept reality. You know, Paul Johnson in his book, A History of Christianity, said that a sincere believer has nothing to fear from the facts. And you don't. God shows you something. Other people show you something. Science shows you something. You learn something you've never seen before. It should just strengthen your Christian outlook because you accept facts, but you grow in faith. You grow in the nurture and the care and the love of Christ through the presence, power of the Holy Spirit, through studying the Scriptures, and through enjoying Christian fellowship with other believers. And look at Matthew 10, verses 11 through 14 to help you see this. You know, you can be blessed or you can be rejected. That's what Jesus told them in those verses. You go somewhere and they love you and they appreciate you and they're thankful for what you're doing for them, then send your blessing to them. And if you go somewhere and you're trying to be good for them and they don't appreciate you at all, and they let you know they don't appreciate you at all, and they're just not very nice, then brush the dust off your feet. And really, it doesn't matter either way as far as your peace of mind. If I go into a situation and it's warm and inviting and loving and I grow and I'm nourished and cared for, then I continue in that situation and bless them. And if some reason it's a bad situation and I just can't be there and be sane and happy and free, then I'll just move on. Either way, I'm blessed. That's what I mean by rigid flexibility. If you have to stay or if you have to go, either way, it's okay. Roll with it. Move through it. You know, don't let the small circumstances of life become big circumstances in your head. Flexibility is a necessity if you want to have a life of serenity and peace. And so this flexibility leads to acceptance sometimes. Rigid flexibility means that there's the proof in the pudding that God is leading your life, that He is with you. Whatever you have or don't have. You know, everybody quotes that scripture in Philippians 4. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And most of the time they're talking about climbing mountains or getting race cars or having great experiences and vacations. But if you read the context of that passage, it's talking about whatever you go through. Whether you have an abundance, which is wonderful, or whether you're suffering need, like many of us are since this COVID pandemic. Whether you abound or whether you suffer need, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And so can you. And that's the message today. Whatever the experiences of your life are right now, let God in the inside of you. When I pray, I'm really trying to open up and let the Father see my innermost being, trying not to play with God, but to be entirely real, open, honest with God. And when you get open, real, and honest with Him, and He touches you and He moves you, He moves some things around. You change a little bit. You have to be pliable. You have to be flexible. He'll help you accept some things that maybe you need to accept. It's been a long time coming. You've been holding on to that grudge for too long. You've been holding on to that resentment for too long. You've been holding on to that selfish behavior that's really not helping anybody, not even you, for too long. Let it go. Let Jesus have it. Let Him have you. And that's the message this morning. Lighten up. Laugh a little. Put life in perspective. Sometimes we get so heavy about things that we just can't even see the fun in life. And sometimes it's not that it's not there. We're just not looking at it right. Don't take it so hard. Roll with the punches. It's not the end of the world, whatever it is. And if it is, this too will pass. This is Tim Carter. Looking forward to being back with you again next week. And I'll try to have something special for you. Here's the contact information. And hope that you will join us again. Make sure to tell your friends about us so that they can come and enjoy these messages with you also. Shit.